So recently I did a live stream where I had chat decide what type of game I was going to make and let them decide the story and everything else about it. So this
is
that.
Boys, what's up, everyone?
Okay, let's get into it. This is the first stream, so don't be too judgmental, okay? Because I'm a lot funnier when I'm able to
edit everything.
Let's just get right into it. So what game are we making, boys? Just spam some ideas in the chat. Pen game? I'm not making no pen game. I suck with pen. First person shooter game? A racing game? Just something cool? Okay. Oh, let's just start off with a platformer. Okay, let's just get this script going. So it was now when I started to code the platforming script. This part was pretty boring, so I figured I'd let you guys out of it. Someone in the middle commented a really good idea, though. Let's do a story-based platformer. So we'll have, like a general story to it. Let's make the ground just a temporary ground. Then we need our guy. So it was back to work on the code. I kept coding and coding and coding until it was perfect. But then someone gave me another idea. The main character dad has murdered and what? And he's going to kill the murderer? Okay. Okay. We can do that. We can do that. And so I finished the platforming script. It was quite embarrassing considering I messed up a few times. But no biggie. Eventually, I did get it working. Okay, I think we're good. Let's just do some of the tests. This is a good way to test it. If you guys are ever needing to test the platforming script, obviously, he's not going to the ceiling. He's going up slopes. And we're good. Okay, what should the main guy look like? A nut? That's actually pretty genius. I'll just do a nut, because that's the only really good idea I've seen so far. So I went to work designing my best nut. Hey, what are you doing? Get out of here! Get out! That looks like Trump. How does this look like Trump? So he's mad, right? Because he just lost his peanut dad. It's the nut family. It's the story of the nut family. My genius idea is that it's the nut family, you know? And an evil squirrel kidnapped their father, Peanut, and then he has to go save his father. What do you boys think? So obviously I just kept working on the guy, making sure he was as high quality as possible. I gave him a little bit of a mouth right here, as you can see. He's a little angry that someone stole his peanut dad, but that's whatever. Then I tried giving him a nose, and people really did not like the nose. So I guess we had to get rid of the nose. No nose? Nose equals nope. No nose, nose be gone. Okay, fine. No nose. Buff arms. Should we give him buff arms? Let's go. Here, let's design the shoulder over here. So we got the delt. We got the bicep. Got one of the tricep heads. That needs to be a little bit lighter than that. This should be a little bit lighter. So like there. Then we have the elbow, obviously. Then we have the forearm. And then the other forearm. And it needs to come to a point. So like that. And then a different shade for both of them, obviously. So I'd say around there. And then he should have his hands in a fist. So let's do it like boom, 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 boom. So obviously I proceeded to try and position the muscles on the muscly acorn or nut because he's angry that his peanut dad got stolen. I mean, wouldn't you be? So obviously I just put it on and then yeah, I was good. Okay, now he's angry. Now he's freaking, now he's about to murk someone. You should at least have some tiny little legs. Let's give him some tiny little legs. Is this good? Okay. I did not intend that. Okay, let's get rid of that little bump. That's gonna be a problem. Scratch will probably ban my account if I show that. So we are going to put that little swirl at the bottom. That's not healthy. Let's give him some knees so he doesn't pass out. So let's give him a walk cycle. So as you expect, that's exactly what I did. I started to animate the nut's walk cycle, making sure that it was beautiful in every aspect. I really wanted to capture that feeling that 180 pounds of flesh, or in this case, nut, was flying towards you. No, what did I do? Does it still look good? Okay, yeah. Now his arm just looks mentally challenged. No, let's reset the arms. I don't know if that was the best idea. So the tale continued. I used squish and squash to make him look better animated, and I made sure to make it nice and smooth. For now, I think that's good. Oh my heck, where'd he go? Where'd you go? Once we got him finished, I knew this was going to be a great game. You can just feel his energy, his anger towards the overlord squirrel. So then I just matched the walk cycle and added it to the platforming script and added a couple of jumping and falling costumes. I'd say the platforming script ended out pretty good with our nut looking like a beast. Let's also set his size a lot smaller. So he seems like he's like moving super quick. Set his size to 50. Good. Oh yeah, now he's ready to dominate, coming to get revenge on his father. No, but what's like the enemy of a nut? Come on guys, what's the enemy of a nut? Give me some good ideas. A bird is an enemy of a nut. No, it isn't. That makes no sense. That's not even like remotely true. A snail? A squirrel is the closest one, but we want the boss to be a squirrel. So instead of enemy of a nut, what's a minion of a squirrel? Nutcracker? A boss nutcracker. No, the nutcracker should be the main boss. You're right. Boss nutcracker, and then the minions are squirrels.
All hail our master, the nutcracker.
Let's start making the level. So, should it be like in a tree? What's the best way to do this? Where should, like, the setting be? What should be the world he travels around? Come on, guys. Give me some good ideas. What's the world he should travel around? A tree. Okay, a tree. Okay, a tree is what we're gonna do. Let's start making the tree. So, obviously, my drawing skills aren't the best, so just bear with me, okay? So, I just had the most brilliant idea, so I just gotta show you guys, okay? This is the tree of destiny, right? Let's give it some leaves. Okay, those leaves are freaking hurting my eyes. Let's make them darker. Here's what I'm thinking. So, in the middle of the tree is a sort of door, okay? And what happens is you start there, right? And it explains the backstory. But there's a key that you have to unlock. Sort of key you have to get to unlock the cage or the boss battle. So it has like 9 different key slots. And what you have to do is you have to travel each of the branches to get one key that goes to the door. And you can only face the boss once you have gotten all the keys. What do you boys think? Okay, we're doing it. And then we can have like a mini map that shows him where he is. So obviously a scrolling level would be a bit ambitious for what we're going for here. So I decided to do a trick where if he touches the right side of the screen, he teleports to the left. Then if he touches the left side of the screen, he teleports to the right. And same thing with the top and bottom. And then we will change the sprite that is our location to the next area. So it'll look like a fully expansive world. Let's see if it works. He jumps. Okay, now he's... Obviously he can go, and it's basically like he's teleporting. But when the costumes change, it's gonna look like he's traveling. And then if we set X and set Y to 0, 0. So now all we have to do is, okay, we can name this one 0, 0. And then if this is 1 to the right, then it's going to be 1, 0. Yeah, so let's have it be like this and like this. So as you can see, we can travel to the right. And then it's going to change it so it looks like he's traveling through. It's slim, thick, delicious. Everyone knows that. So let's get to making the art. So let's make a ground too, but instead this just be the back decoration. So if you're ever making a platformer, a really cool trick you can do is, for example, let's have some back decoration so I can just show. And then let's have this one go back 5 layers. As you can see, that's not the desired effect. As you can see now, it looks like a tree, right? And if you wanted, you could put stuff like, let's say, grass or whatever, like maybe leaves. Let's just make some leaves. So as you can see, these leaves are like now in the background. So if we can walk by it and they're in the background. But let's say you want to have some depth to it, then you can duplicate and make it be called front decoration. And then obviously we're going to have to get rid of this. We are going to forever go to front as well. So as you can see, if we like move these ones a little bit over here, make them a little bit smaller, lighten up their shade a little bit. Now he like is going through them, and it makes this like really weird, like, I don't know if you guys can see it, but like 3D effect. He's like going behind some and going in front of others. It's just a cool trick we're gonna use to make our game a lot more realistic. So obviously I finished making a demo level sort of area that I just continue testing on to make sure that it like looks all good and the concept is there. What should we do? There's so many things we need to do, and I can't even decide what we should do first. So then is what started was the most unproductive 15 minutes of my life. Now, this is a horrible state to be at when you're making a game. You know the general idea of the game, but you don't really know the exact details. It can be very frustrating to get started on working on it. So I thought, hey, how about we just plan out the entire level? But it did not work good at all, because in order to plan out the entire level, I need to have at least a basic grasp of the game's mechanic, which I did not. So eventually I just realized I just had to start designing the level and to sort of place keys where they fit instead of trying to plan it all out. This is gonna take forever. I just like all of a sudden realized, you know what, let's just start doing it. We're just gonna hide this. Planning is for losers. If you plan, you're a loser. I didn't really mean that, but yes I did. Okay, let's add a big honkin' trunk that is attached. So right here, okay, this is the main trunk, and then set the ground to like right here, and then let's get some of these front decorations, and then let's get some of these back decorations. So ba 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 ba. So I finally started to get in my stride. I actually started to feel like I was making meaningful progress designing the layout and gameplay of the level. So I was just designing the center place where the boss is going to be accessible once you get all the keys. Someone in chat actually suggested a really, really good idea. So instead of keys, which really don't fit with this world, they said let's do parts of a nut. And you have to collect all the parts of a nut. This is really cool and really interesting, and it fits with our whole theme very well. Now it's looking a lot better, and then we're going to add some more stuff. Let's actually change the color of the sky. It's a bit depressing. Like that? Yeah, that's a lot better. Okay, and then we should make the branches. So let's just add some branches to keep up the tree aesthetic, if you know what I mean. So we have branches going everywhere. Let's make them super thick. And then obviously we're at the base of the tree, or like in the center of it. So it should just be like leaves everywhere. And then let's get this like that. Let's make the green a little bit darker. Okay, there we go. And then we can start to add leaves and everything. And that's exactly what I did. I just sort of finished designing the main area, which was essential if I wanted to get started designing on the rest of the game. So eventually I got it to a high enough standard. Okay, I think that's a good start to our game. It's got the main physics and everything. It's got a little bit of animation, the main concept all fleshed out. But yeah, with me tired and our game finally looking like a game, I finished off the first live stream, knowing that our game was well on its way. Okay, let's get working on the game. So, if you guys remember, all we have right now is our fella that is able to jump around and everything. But we want to add some more stuff. So, let's actually get working on the levels. So I figured I'd start off with adding some new mechanics. I didn't want to start with any enemies or anything. I just wanted to start off with something simple I could do with the platformer. So I thought of
a bouncy mushroom.
What color is the mushroom that bounces the player? What color is it going to be? Okay, it seems like most of you guys are going red. So we're going to make it red. Let's start designing it, I guess. What then ensued was very interesting. I never knew how bad I was at designing mushrooms until this very instance where I saw. I mean, it's a mushroom. It's detailed, complex. Please don't roast me. I tried my hardest. You boys can't judge me. I bet you guys can even do a mushroom that good. If you guys want to know how to do rounded edges in Scratch for your squares, you make sure it's on this. You go like that. You add a couple circles like you do. You add another rectangle like that. And then you readjust it so it's perfect. And then boom. You have a nice rounded square. After this, I goofed up a little bit on the screen. Oh no, sorry. Yikes. No, guys, what I added was I just added a sort of area. I added fisheye to the mushroom, and then I added a sort of place where he bounces up onto. After I had done this, I knew I had to make it up to the viewer somehow so they wouldn't leave. So I came up with an idea. And I want to add an Easter egg. I want to add someone's name, like, right down here or something.
Well played. Well played.
So, I'm just going to pick a random comment. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3... 2, 1. Okay, it's Angry Spud 3839. Angry Spud. Okay, let's see. Angry Spud. Let's add your name in. Let's make it like so it's like really very unnoticeable. Angry Spud. Let's add it to like a leaf. So like there's a leaf hanging right here. We just put that forward. It's the Angry Spud leaf. You're welcome. You can barely see it. Yeah, what an amazing Easter egg. I think we should start work on the enemies. What should the enemies be able to do? Like, should they throw nuts or should they, like, just chase him? Should they slow him down? What is a good enemy type? Flying squirrels. Maybe they should like charge him. Here, I got an idea. So they'll be waiting, and if they see him, they'll charge up and then they'll try to leap towards him for an attack. And let's just try and do that.
Time to design the squirrel.
This hunched over look to them is actually pretty good. Makes them look evil. If we were to add some like hands, like he is plotting his revenge on this dumb little nut. Cancer. Okay, yeah, that is freaking like what the schlong. If I saw that in real life, boy, I'd be booking down the freaking other direction.
5 minutes later.
I think that is all we need.
The screen froze again after this, so people got mad.
Don't worry, guys. Here. Mr. Squirrel has something to say. I apologize for my actions. I sincerely do. I'm sorry. Okay, anyways, this is our guy, our squirrel. He's hunched over. He looks like a freaking cheeky mother flipper.
Watch your profanity.
And he's gonna pounce on the player. Oh wait, we still need his tail.
nice and floofy. There we go. Let's make the eyes bigger, because apparently they need to be. Oh, actually, that was actually a pretty smart move, not gonna lie. And now they look more like squirrels. Someone said make them thicker. I guess we could give them a nice beer belly. They've been eating a little too much nuts, so. He's packing on a few pounds for the winter, I guess. The tail could be bigger, I guess. Yeah, what will they look like in the level, though? That's what I want to know. Is that good?
I don't know if that's good.
Maybe we add eyes that are like that. So let's do like, first let's rename him Thickalicious Thick Squirrel, because why not? Guys, how do you spell squirrel? Okay, wait. SQUIRLLL. Okay. SQUIRELREL. Okay, there we go. The Thickalicious Thick Squirrel. How big should we make him? Should he be like, freaking like, no, that's like boss status. Maybe like, here, I'll give you guys three options. We have this level, and then this level. Out of 1, 2, and 3, which size should he be? Boom!
Bars!
Out of 1, 2, and 3, which size should he be? Everybody is watching me. How many people you ask, I don't know. But what I know is I've got the flow. So which size, boys? 1, 2, or 3? Most of you are saying 2. Mix of 1 and 2. Okay. 4? What? Okay, let's go between a mix of 1 and 2. Like, a little bit smaller than this.
With our character designed, it was time to get started on the coding.
Okay, so let's do forever point towards the guy. Wait, we can't name him guy. What are we doing? He's the nut.
The nut.
Okay, so he points towards him. Now we need to, So what we needed to design was a costume for his charge up. When he's getting ready to jump towards the player. When he's getting ready for the leap.
The nut.
So he's pointing towards the nut. Let's give him his fly costume. So this is his charge costume. This is his idle costume. This is his...
I believe I can...
costume. So, you know, he goes, charges up. Boo! Leap. Okay. I have actually done this sort of thing once before. Let me pull it up. Okay, so if we go to my profile, my Star Wars story mode, which is a great game, by the way. If you haven't played it, check it out. We're almost at 100,000 views on it. So if we play it, as you can see, if I skip right towards the boss, watch. The way he moves. Look, he will jump and go. See? He like, that's sort of what we want. It's actually pretty easy to do that. We just have to, blah, blah, blah. No one cares, okay? The coding is boring. We just want to see what he's like when he actually starts to fly. As you can see, he will go, he will jump. And he's actually going to jump a lot farther. Right now looks pretty pathetic, you know? He'll jump and it'll be like... really stupid, but actually it's gonna look pretty cool. Stop it with your pathetic jumps, they're weak, and you know it.
5 minutes later.
Let's see what it looks like now. Okay, no. No, what are you doing? That is exactly what I'm like when I'm in an uncomfortable situation. You know, you just like, let's get out of there, wee. Okay. Let's actually switch these out. Let's see. So he charges up. Okay, now he's leaping towards. were like running around. Ah, frick! Get away from me! Ah! Oh yeah, now he's... This is what we want. Okay, to dodge him, we gotta like... Shoot, he's coming! Run! Stay away from me, you dirty rat. Let's set their sizes a little bit smaller. Okay, so it leaps at us. Cool. And then if it hits us while it's leaping, that's when it does damage. And then the way to kill it is you have to wait until it's like going. And then you gotta run. And then, you know, avoid it. And then you're supposed to hit it when it's resting or charging up. So that's where the mechanics come in. Okay, our leaping squirrel is now terrifying. And it's just perfect. It's perfect, boys. Our game is starting to come together.
5 minutes later.
What about the sound? Should we like do some temporary sound? Okay, basically what I did was I changed it to white for his eyes. So now he looks like a freaking crack addict. But I still think it's better than the black. Here, should we add a sound to him?
Wow!
Wow! Oh, frick. That's loud. So if we add the sound.
Wow!
Oh my heck, that's terrifying.
Wow!
Oh my egg. Oh, goodbye. Goodbye, my friend. Too bad you're never going to get back here. No more. The wah needs to freaking go. Because that's literally scared me half to death. Okay, let's see. We need to have the guy be able to attack. I say we start working on his attack animation and his attack engine. So, he's pissed, obviously. So when you like punch, you like wind your arm back, right? So let's have him like. So. And then this is where we pop it off. What looks like so far. It's looking pretty crappy, not gonna lie.
Oh!
Boys, I have identified the problem. You throw a punch, you're not gonna have your arm out. You are going to have it in like this. Like, hey, come at me, fool. Is that looking better? Now it looks like he's actually punching, right? And now he's like freaking like yamming it, like, get over here. Get. Now what does your legs do in a punch? Let's see. So you raise your opposite leg, so like this, then you like charge up on this leg. So you go what? Okay, that's starting to look more like a punch. That's what it's gonna look like normally. I think we should have him jump a little bit. So as you can see, his range of motion is like boom, 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 boom.
5 minutes later.
Guys, I'm not gonna make the freaking nut dab, okay? So we have our guy, he can move. The squirrel tries to attack us. Now we can go up to it. Oh, oh, oh. You know, run away. Oh, oh, oh. Run away. Boom, boom, boom. You guys seem to like the sound effects, so I guess we can add some sound effects.
Skadoosh! 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 Skadoosh!
Then we have the screaming.
Ah!
It's too long. His flight will not be that long.
Ah!
Okay, so we can run.
Ah!
Oh, freaking heck. So we attack, run. Okay, our game is looking very saucy. We could add particle effects to the player though. So we have one that is a poof when he lands. Make sure you guys go watch my special video where I explain particle effects, because it's a beast of a tutorial. Okay, so let's test out this. It's going good. Let's set the ghost effect to like 50. And then let's also make sure that it's positioned at the right place.
Like way down here.
Okay, that's some good particle effects. It's pretty good, right? Wouldn't you say? And he lands like, yeah, I've come to kill you. Whoosh. Let's just work on some rain. Rain. So if you guys ever want to make rain, the best technique I have found is to just go make a dark blue rain droplet and then rotate it perfectly. Now you just duplicate the crap out of it. Then what you do is you name that one, duplicate it, you select everything, you move it down like that much, duplicate it again, move it down once more, then you create a ton of new ones. Now if you do forever next costume, looks like rain, let's like wait 0.05 seconds, 0.03 seconds, 2, 1, okay, and then you set ghost effect to 80, somewhere around there. As you can see, you now have rain and it's beautiful. As you can see, we now have rain if we want to add it. For now, I'm gonna hide it. I don't know if we're gonna use it actually, but maybe we do like changing weather or something. I have a passion for rain. The sort of mood that rain gives off is one that I love. And especially when it's like lightning every once in a while. It just, oh, the perfect atmosphere. I don't know about you guys, but I get extremely nostalgic when I smell rain. Like, oh, yes. Yes. We added a bouncing thing. We added particle effects underneath the player. We added the possibility of rain. We added, of course, we have the enemy that tries to attack us. Then we have the punching animation where we can punch the squirrel. Yeah, so far it's going really well. Let's get started on health. So let's make a variable for the nut and let's name it health. Well, first let's set health to like 10. And then we can show health. I'll be right here. And then we can do if touching the player or the nut. The nut. Can change health by -1. So if he goes and he hits us, he takes away our health. It's about 3 per time. So it's pretty scary. We can raise the base level health to like 50. But yeah, so around 3 health every time he hits us. Yeah, so we're obviously gonna do a health bar
in the future.
But yeah, after a very productive second live stream, it was time to call it quits. But luckily our game was very on the way to becoming the most amazing game ever created.
It was making progress.
Luckily, boys, there's no problem with the screen anymore because I have gotten my second monitor. So I will know when you guys are not seeing the fun. So last thing we were working on was our health bar. We should probably make it less ugly. Like not this, that is really ugly. So let's start on that. What are we going to do for the health bar of our player? Leaves? Leaves are actually not a bad idea. Heart-shaped nuts, stick, leaves, nut juice, what? Let's make a new sprite, call it the nut health. Maybe they should be like heart-shaped leaves. So like maybe so I think this is a good idea for the health, and then we can just have like a couple of them, you know. What do you boys think? Gay? Really gay? Okay, is a heart is not gay? Freaking heck, get your facts right. What else would you want besides these amazing
leaves?
How many lives will he have? I don't know. I say 3 because the attacks are going to be big. They're going to be like one things. You know what I mean? add some shading. We could add some shading. Good trick is just to duplicate it, get the original color, do it a little bit darker, get all three of them, group them together, put them right here, and then put it to the back. Okay, like that. More details on the leaves. We can add more detail. What's wrong with my leaf? I feel like something's wrong with my leaf. Undo.
5 minutes later.
You know what? You boys forced my hand. We're doing nuts. Because for some reason right now, I cannot design a simple leaf. I say that's a good health indicator. Get out of here, you dumb leaf. I don't like you. I actually think it's a good idea. But that's just me. I don't know what you guys think. But yeah, that's what I sort of think. I say we get someone else's opinion. You boys want to get someone else's opinion? Yoink! No, you can't have any. You can't have any. Get out of here.
But I want some.
Get out of here. You filthy, filthy dude. You can't have any. You're the reason why there's world fighting because of you split the continents and we were all one together. So shut your mouth and get out of here. So, yeah, get out of here. Get out of here. Oh, I hate that dude. He always screws everything up. So we got that. Let's hide this health variable. Let's shrink it down to size. Like 80%, I'd say. Like, I think that's pretty good. Let's have it go there. Go to there. And then, let's get, like, I feel like we want it to, like, float. So, I feel like we should get one of those algorithms, if you know what I mean. Let's look up a sign algorithm. What's a good sign algorithm? I feel like I might even have to, like, watch my own tutorial. Because I'm struggling to find it. Timer minus one. Okay, so this is not what we wanted. That's a transition one. Okay, where's the other one? Cosine, actually. Okay, yeah, this is the floating. So, I think we should have it go way quicker. Even maybe, like, quicker than that. Let's have the amplitude be like, yeah, like that. That's nice and alive. And then 155. It's about where we wanted it, so... Actually, that's a little too distracting. Maybe 500. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty good. Nice and just floating right there. What's the opinion on the street? Dabnut.
Why is chat never able to stay on topic?
Will this be on Xbox? Of course I could get signed by Xbox. What do you mean? So we can run, and the health up there is really nice. And let's set health to 5. Now we just need to switch to costume health. If we change health by -1. We want him to like bounce off us. So let's do like... I know this is looking pretty confusing, but if you guys see now, he'll come, he'll try to jump, he'll go wink. Nope, I forgot to take this out. Hey, let's dodge him real quick. So let's say we're running around, right? He comes at us. Oh, frick. That's not good. That is freaking OP as flip. So we cannot do that. So -1, I guess. Let's try -1. Okay. That's working, I think. So he tries to attack us. Yoink. Nope, that is because then we can't punch him. Let's actually not do the change X any different. So now he'll just jump at us and just keep going. Actually, I don't know if that's gonna work. Okay, so if he hits us, yoink. Is that good? Will that work in like rough games though? No, see? I guess the best thing we could do is just put all this back. Not do any of this. So he's sort of back to his old self, you know, of jumping just towards the player. And then what we can do is on the player's end, we can do. That should work. Let's see. So we can run around. Okay, and then he can hit us and do some hefty damage. Yeah, it's working. So let's figure this out. So what should we do when the player like hits, or what should we add? Because I feel like it's feeling a little bit dry. I need some advice of what to add. What should we add, if you know what I mean? Let's make it so our player can hurt the squirrel. So let's go to the squirrel forever. If touching player, oh wait, the nut. I forgot the nut. So we'll do if touching the nut, then we are going to. So it comes. We can. What? What just happened? Touching the nut and. Oh, wait. 14, right? The costume number 15. So we actually gotta go up here to 15. Now he just obliterates it in one hit. I don't think that is what we want. That is a little too OP. I do wish I had that for my life problems, you know? Like, someone's coming at me, and I'm just like, yoink. Sorry, dude. Oh, it doesn't look all weird, so. Yoink, 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 yoink. I think it's looking good. So if we go now. Yoink, yoink. Okay, it's looking good. Let's set the squirrel health to like 20. That way we can test. Yoink, 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 yoink. Now he's shaking a little bit. Let's do 10 to 100 on the whirl effect. See if it, yoink. Okay, now it looks like we're punching him, and then yeah, it looks like we're going pretty good. Yoink. Okay, now it looks like we're punching him. It looks like we're going pretty good. So I guess what we can do now is simply make it so he stops hurting the player when he's just walking around. How do we do that? I guess we have to do that on the squirrel. So now he won't hurt just when walking around. It's only when he
goes like that.
Let's have him forever point towards the nut also, because it's not really looking that good when he's just
not even doing it.
So let's do that. Now he's like charging, and then he's going all good. I don't know about you guys, but I feel like the level is a little bit too big, or like we're too zoomed in. So I still wanna like set our guys smaller. I say like 20. 20% is solid. That way there's like more room to do stuff. Okay, now he's freaking going pretty far. Yeah, this may be a little bit smaller than we want, but it still has the desired sort of effect that we want. See, this seems like there's more like depth to the gameplay, that it's a lot more potential for things to happen. Let's set the size to like 30. I actually think that that's a good size. Yeah, I think that's good. That's a lot more better in my opinion. Let's add some more player feedback. Let's actually like, let's wait 0.1 seconds. And then let's also like, instead of just doing the whirl, let's set his brightness to like negative 20. That way it's like player feedback. So, you know, he comes at us, go up. Ooh, oh, you know, really put some damage in. Comes at us, we can keep beating him. Comes at us, yoink. Oh, run, you know, get out of the way. Start to really put in the damage. Let's make his thing faster, because I feel like his charge is way too slow. So let's balance it a little bit. So let's wait 0.5 seconds for both. Let's see if that's better. What's this? Yeah. Feel like this is way better. Let's actually have, I don't like him being able to like if you see when he jumps. Like, I don't want him to be able to hit when he's jumping up. Only when he's, like, falling down. So I say that we do it so it's Y velocity is less than 1 or 0. That way, it is only happening when he's coming down for the strike, if you know what I mean. So if we go now, then if he hits us, he can hit us only on the strike down, which makes it a lot more intuitive. Now this is where we really add the dynamic to the game. We don't want this guy to be like this the whole time. That kind of ruins the feel I feel like we're going for. So we should only have him be trying to get the guy if he has line of sight. So as you can see, what our code is now doing is it's constantly checking to see if the squirrel has sort of a line of sight with the player by seeing if this line intersects. So if we forever have him say line of sight, see right now he has line of sight, right now he doesn't. If he falls, true, line of sight. Now you boys understand how it works. And the cool thing is if we create two clones, as you can see, both of them will work independent of each other. So now what we can do is the squirrel can charge us, but if we're hiding from it, then it won't charge us. So as you can see, it's working pretty well. And with that ended the third live stream, with our game well on its way to becoming something great.